Hi, YouTube family. Hope everyone is doing really well. This is a little bit more of a laid-back, kickback video where I'm going to share with you some of my top favorites for YouTubers that I love to watch and a little bit of the reasons why. These are just people that either I've been watching for quite a while or I've just discovered very recently because I've been trying really to branch out and find as many new channels as I possibly can. So before I go into my list, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe by clicking the red button below. Don't forget to hit the bell icon. If anybody hasn't done that yet, that's how you get notified of the videos that I put up that are brand new. And I post beauty videos, makeup videos, 3 times a week on Mondays, Thursdays, and Saturdays between 4 and 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So at least you guys have a schedule now. Gosh, I've been doing this for 3 years and I haven't had a schedule. Hopefully that schedule will hold. That is my plan for now. I got through the first week, so I think I'm doing pretty darn good. Okay, let's get into the list. The first couple that I'm going to talk about are a little bit bigger YouTubers. They are YouTubers that I've been watching for a really long time. I'm gonna put him right up there at the beginning because, I'm sorry, this man is a makeup god. He is Wayne Goss, that you all know and love. This man teaches, and that's what I love about his channel. You can see his videos and go through and find just about anything that you could ever imagine that you might need to learn about makeup application. And he is so simplistic in what he does, and yet it is so effective, and I love that about it, that you can go and you can take away from his video and you can try it yourself and go, okay, I can see how that can work. And you can, you know, tweak it a little bit for your own eyes or your own face and realize that, oh my goodness, this is really a good technique. This is really a technique that comes from a makeup artist, because you know that he has tried it over again and they're the best ones that he's found. And I just love that about him. So Wayne Goss has to be my number one. Now, the rest of these ladies, they're not in any particular order. The next one that you all know and love is Emily Noel. This gal has been on here for 10 years. She has had 2 palettes that she released that were just fantastic hits that we all love, the Wants and the Needs palette through Makeup Revolution. She is amazing in how she incorporates her reviews with always trying things on. I think that is so commendable because she's trying it on right before your eyes. So you can actually see how that product would work and how it would do, you know, on real-time skin. And I think that is great about it. She also goes into a lot of drugstore. She doesn't just stick with high-end. She does throw her high-end stuff in there that she gets as PR or something that is really talked about at the moment. But she really does love drugstore, and she goes back to her drugstore roots when she's talking to us, and I love that about her. The next one that I want to talk to you about is Andrea Matalano. I hope I'm not saying that. It might be Mataliano. I'm not sure. Andrea is a younger gal, but what I love about Andrea is she's so personable and she's so easy when she's in front of the camera. She's been doing it a long time too. She has really great reviews on drugstore and high-end products. She also does a lot of declutters. She does a lot of Shop My Stash. I know that in the past she's done some Project Pans. I don't know if she's doing anything like that or not right now. But Andrea, to me, she's just a very easy person to watch. I love watching her. She does a lot of close-up swatches, which I really appreciate also. Whenever she's giving recommendation, you do get to see those close-up swatches. That's really great. To me, she's just a really, really sweet gal that I really enjoy watching, and she's really soothing to me for some reason, so I really do enjoy her. The next one is Allie Glines. If any of you have ever seen Allie, she is also really easy to watch, but I love that Allie takes so many different things, so many different things she's tried. She re-reviews things. She goes back to those things that she's hauled. She lets you know whether or not they were good or not. She does get a lot of PR, so she gets a lot of those things before everybody does, so she can try those on for us. And I just really have grown attached to her. She has given me some fantastic, really, really fantastic recommendations from the drugstore. So I love her for that too. And I do have a tendency to lean a lot towards drugstore reviewers or drugstore beauty YouTubers because they're kind of more along in the lines of what I can afford. I do love to see the luxury stuff too, but the ones that I kind of gravitate towards are those that do a little bit more drugstore. The next one is Zabrina. If you guys have ever seen her, oh my gosh, isn't she gorgeous? That gorgeous fiery red hair, and she always has, you know, just the most intensely beautiful eye makeup. And Zabrina, I kind of started following her years and years and years ago, way before she ever had a baby. I just feel like she is one of those YouTubers that is down to earth, very easy. She always has Frugal Fridays, which I think was so much fun, where she goes in and she does some review on something from the drugstore or something that's very inexpensive. And I love that about it. She also does have whole entire months where she just devotes it to very affordable makeup or drugstore makeup. So I do love that about her too. But I feel like Zabrina has grown up as a woman in front of my eyes. She's gotten married, had babies, all that stuff, and now she has her second child. And I just feel like she's somebody that's like a friend that you sit down with. So that's why I love Zabrina. She's extremely thorough on her reviews. And if she does get anything like Wet n Wild or Rimmel or any of those that are really less expensive brands, she's going to make sure that she does a whole in-depth review about it. Like the Rebel Rose collection from Wet n Wild, she did a complete review about it, and I absolutely loved listening to her about that because I knew immediately what I was going to like. And one of the reasons that I do watch Zabrina, because I am a YouTuber, I'm a YouTuber with dry skin, and Zabrina has very, very oily skin. And so for me, that's really helpful because somebody will say to me, you know, what about having oily skin? And I'll think, what did Zabrina do? Because she has extremely oily skin. So I can almost tell you immediately how something will hold up compared, you know, with her if you have oily skin. And if you do have oily skin, you're going to be wanting to watch her. Because not only does she have oily skin, she lives in a very humid climate. So anything that lasts on that girl is going to last on anybody. I can tell you that. It's really good. Okay, the next one that I want to talk about is Everyday Heidi. I came across Heidi's channel because she had done this cheaper and better video. She came up with this video where it was a dupe video, but she named it cheaper and better. And I have done that many times, and they're great successes on my channel. And I guess it's just the thought of it being something from the drugstore that is better than high end, and I just thought it was genius of her to come up with this. Besides that video, she does have really interesting content on her channel. She does all the reviews and all of those regular things like the Sephora VIB, the Ulta, da da da. I think the reason that I really like her too is because she also loves color like I do, and she's not afraid to use color. She also likes a really good bargain from the drugstore, so she's always looking at that. But she reviews so many things, and I really like listening to her too. She's younger again, but I really have enjoyed the videos that I've watched from her. My next one is Samantha March. Any of you guys that have not seen Samantha, please go watch Samantha. This gal, she is amazing. I think the reason that I was so drawn to Samantha in the beginning is one of the very first videos I watched of hers was last year, and it was about her anxiety and her depression and what she deals with. But Samantha has overcome all of that, and she tries so hard, and she talks about her life. She wears her heart on her sleeve. I think that's why I'm really drawn to her, because I'm that same kind of person where it usually, if it's in there, it's going to come bubbling out somehow, and I just hope that it doesn't come bubbling out in a weird way or a way that offends anybody. But Samantha doesn't do that. That's not what I'm saying. I was drawn to her because of her personality as far as being so open. And Samantha is working her butt off for her channel. She does videos like 6 or 7 videos a week. She is just kicking butt, taking names and kicking butt. And she really is doing a good job. She's very inclusive with her videos. She does a lot of different things. She has a Will I Buy It series where she goes over the new things that are coming out each week. She also always follows up on her haul videos and whether or not she liked those products, which I really do like about her too. The next one on my list is Penn Smith Skincare, Penny. Penny is an advanced esthetician, and she used to be a hairdresser too. And if you need to know anything about skincare, that gal is a wealth of knowledge. I could just sit and listen to her all day long about her skincare knowledge. And she gives such good recommendations for the products and tells you why that product works and what the best product is. And she goes into it, and she has helped me dramatically with what I have been using on my dry skin. So great that she also used to do hair too, because she has a lot of really great suggestions for that as well. But I love watching Penny. She has the most piercing, gorgeous, bright, bright blue eyes. And it's just no nonsense with her as well. What her knowledge is, she's going to help you understand in layman's terms what she's learned as somebody that is a professional. And I love that about her. So if you haven't had a chance to go over and watch Penny, I love her to death. with. Another one that I absolutely love is Mary Glitzy Fritzy. And I think this gal is amazing. She is a mature beauty YouTuber. And when Mary sits down to do a review of whatever she chooses to do, she does a complete review, and you are going to get the most in-depth review of for your mature skin of anybody I have seen. She does a fantastic job, and she usually does the whole entire line. She'll go through the whole entire line of what she's doing. She does that a lot on her channel, and I have loved that about seeing, you know, how different skincare has affected her skin. And her and I have a lot of the same tastes in makeup too, so I know that if Mary likes it, I'm probably gonna like it too. So I would really recommend that you go over and see her, and don't leave her videos early, you guys. You need to stay to the end. And once you see one, you'll know why. It's a treat. So make sure you go over and see her. The next one that I have is Lip Gloss Leslie. If you guys have not seen Leslie, she is so stinking adorable. I love her to pieces. If you want to know about any palette that is drugstore or cost-effective, affordable palette, like from Bad Habit or from Face Candy, Rimmel, any of those, BH Cosmetics, all of those, if you want to know about any palette, you're thinking about any palette, Leslie has reviewed it. You're going to be able to see swatches of those, and you're going to be able to see her do a mini tutorial of it on her eyes. This girl is amazing, and she deserves so many more subscribers than she has. But yeah, you want to talk taking names and kicking butt. Leslie does that with all of her reviews. She also has something that I look forward to, which is Friday Favorites and Fooies. I love that little series from her. It is so good. I look forward to it. It's like Friday. Okay, it's Friday. I got to find Leslie's video, because she goes through the things that she's liking for the week. They might be new things to her, but they are more than likely things that she is just rediscovering in her stash. And I like that about it too. She has a cute personality as well. She usually starts her videos out with a little blooper, which I think is just an easy way to start a video with, just making you feel really at ease. Okay, the last person that I want to talk about is one of my very, very dear friends, and that is a Graceful Beauty Sherry. Sherry has only been on YouTube about a year, but this gal has exploded. She is a mature beauty YouTuber, but you know, I've become friends with Sherry off the camera because we did a collab one time, and we just developed this ease about us. And you know, when she first started out, I'm like, how in the world is she doing that? How is she getting so many views? But if you saw her original couple of videos, one of them she did on how to cover grays in 10 seconds or something like that, and it just exploded. That video, everybody wanted to know how to cover your grays in just a few minutes, and that's really how she got most of her subscribers to begin with, and then she just took off from there. Because Sherry is such an easy person to listen to. And I'm telling you, what you see on the camera with Sherry is every bit exactly what she is in person. She is the funnest, bubbliest, cutest thing. She exudes class. And yet she is so down to earth and so loving inside. And I have just been so drawn to her, and we have this great friendship now. And I would not miss one of her videos for anything. She shoots from the hip. She tells you exactly how she feels about things. She had a very controversial video a while back, and I realized how hard it was for her to be caught up in the middle of that. And she just doesn't, you know, she just doesn't buy into all the YouTube junk and the garbage that goes on and the politics and everything. And that's really kind of where our mature beauty community is anyway. We like to push away from that and be separate from it. We all love each other so much. So I would highly recommend that you go over and see Sherry, Graceful Beauty, again. Sherry is like me about answering everybody's comments. So if you ask her a question or you have a comment on her video, you're gonna get an answer from her, which I think is really special. We don't see that a lot from YouTubers, hardly answering anybody's questions anymore. So I think that you will really enjoy watching her. So that is it, you guys. That's my top 10 beauty YouTubers. I'm gonna make sure that I list all of their channels below. If you guys go over and you check them out, make sure you write them a comment and tell them that I sent you there. I would love for them to know how much I enjoy them and that I sent you guys too. So please give this video a thumbs up if you wouldn't mind. It really does help me. Oh, you guys, don't forget in the comment section below to please tell me who your favorite YouTubers are. Tell me three, tell me five, however many you want to tell me. Just tell me who your favorite YouTubers are. I would love to hear that from you. Take care of yourselves. I love you all so very much. Catch you all in my very next video. Bye-bye, guys.